When you use a database to search for articles from magazines, newspapers, and journals, you'll begin by entering a combination of terms to find the resources you need within the database. The terms you enter in the search bar are known as a search string. If you're familiar with Google, Yahoo, or similar internet search engines, you're experienced with creating basic search strings. However, when searching academic databases, it can be helpful to know about creating more advanced search strings to optimize the quality of your search results. Academic databases generally don't have an understanding of natural language. That is, searching a database means telling it which words to look for, but the database doesn't actually interpret the meaning of those words for the most part. For example, if you type a full sentence or question into a web search engine like Google, it will often be able to provide you with a simple answer. If you enter, "What is the biggest cause of global warming?" into Google, for example, you'll get a lot of results, including a straightforward answer from the World Wildlife Foundation. Enter the exact same question into Academic Search Complete, however. You'll see only three results, none of which appear to be particularly well-suited to answer that specific question. This is because Academic Search Complete doesn't understand that you're looking for the answer to a question, and instead is trying to search for each of these individual words in the database. When creating a search string for an academic database, you need to think more in terms of what words you want to see in your results rather than what ideas or concepts. There are some words and symbols that the database does understand, though, and these will help you tell the database what you want to search for. These special tools are called operators. The operators we'll discuss here are and, or, and not, as well as quotation marks, parentheses, and the wildcard. These operators will greatly help you in broadening, narrowing, and adjusting your search strings. First, let's look at and, or, and not. Typing and between two search terms will make the search engine try to find both of them in the same article. Typing or will tell the search engine to search for either of the terms you entered, and typing not will tell the search engine to omit all results that contain the search term that follows. In general, and not will narrow down your results, while or will broaden your results. Here's an example. Searching for animal and rights, we'll try to find both animal and rights in an article. Animal or rights, we'll try to find articles that have animal in them and articles that have rights in them. While animal not rights, we'll give you articles that have the word animal, but not articles that also include the word rights. Parentheses will tell the search engine to do that operation first, just like in math. If you're researching the effects of violent video games on young people, for example, you might want to type parentheses violent or violence, close parentheses, and parentheses video games or computer games or gaming, close parentheses. This will give you a wide variety of results, thanks to that or in there, that are specifically about what you want to search for. However, you can also save yourself some time typing with the wildcard. The asterisk is a wildcard. If you place it at the end of a search term, it will search for every possible combination of letters and characters that can go in the place of that asterisk. So, for example, searching for GAM asterisk will simultaneously search for gaming, games, and gamer. Of course, it will also search for words like gamey, gamete, and anything else that starts with GAM. So be careful with the wildcard and make sure you have something in your search that helps you narrow it down. For our video game violence search, for example, we might end up with a search string that looks something like this. Parentheses video or computer and GAM asterisk and violen asterisk and parentheses effect asterisk or psych asterisk or develop asterisk or addict asterisk close parentheses and parentheses youth or teen asterisk close parentheses. By putting synonyms connected with the operator or in parentheses, you're able to have the database search for different terms that mean the same thing at the same time. So if we enter this entire search string into Academic Search Complete, we will see that we end up with a fairly large amount of results. And they are all centered exactly on the topic that we want. It'll search for everything from video game violence to psychological effects of computer game violence to computer game addiction in teenagers and all other combinations of those terms that we've entered. One other thing to know is that you can type this kind of search string directly into the basic search box, or you can use the advanced search page to build a search string using drop-down menus to select and or not. You'll get the same kind of results no matter what you do. It just depends on what kind of entry method you find most useful. So if we put in a kind of simplified version of the long search string we just created, like video games or computer games, and V-I-O-L-E-N asterisk, we're going to get that search that searches for video games and violence, computer games and violence, video games and violent teenagers.